You know, we do have counselors. Father Hubley is very good.
No, no, that's the last thing that we need.
Why do you say that?
Because then everybody's talking about
Look,
it.
Look, why do you have to be so close-minded? You see, this is the attitude.
I'm not close-minded.
Ugh, what are you doing right now? This is who you are. Why can't you just talk about things, huh? Talk!
You know, I have to say that you're actually exhibiting some of the very traits that seem to jump off the page in Michael's book.
Who?
You.
Wait a minute. First of all, it's not a book. It's pieces of construction paper.
You sound a bit close-minded.
Hey. Eileen, you have no idea what I have to put up with. When I got married, I didn't just get a husband. I got a whole freak show that set up their tent right across the street. And that would be fine if they stayed there. But every day, they dump a truckload of their insane family dreck into my lap. How would you like to sit through two people in their 60s fighting over who invented the lawn? The lawn! And then the brother.
I live in an apartment. I don't even have a lawn. Raymond has a lawn.
But you can't blame him when you see who the mother is. She has this kind of sick hold on the both of them. And the father's about as disgusting a creature as God has ever dropped on this planet. So no wonder the kid writes stories. I should be writing stories. My life is a gothic novel. And until you have lived in that house with all of them in there with you day after day, week after week, year after friggin' year, you are in no position to judge me.